You are healing everyone. I worship you. I worship you. You worship you. I worship you. You are here healing everyone. I worship you. I worship. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, lies in the darkness. My God, there is who you are. I don't know what you are believing God for. He is a waymaker. He is a miracle worker. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, lies in the darkness. My God, there is who you are. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we worship you. Begin to worship the Lord, the promise keeper, the promise keeper. Begin to worship him this time around. Begin to worship him. Exalt his holy name. Thank the Lord God Almighty for safety, for how he granted us journey mercy from our various places and brought us here safely. Let's appreciate the Lord God Almighty and thank him for the life that he has given unto us this morning. Thank God for the gift of life in the mighty name of Jesus. Not all that slept that we are able to wake up, that we are able to make it this morning. Appreciate the Lord God Almighty. Even if you don't have anything to say, say, Father, I thank you for the gift of life. I worship you. It is only the living that praise the Lord. It is only the living that worship the Lord. Those that are dead, and you that are alive, if you will not worship the Lord, he said he will raise sons to do that. Will you like God to replace you with a son this morning? My sister, let's open our heart this morning. Open your mouth and pray unto the Lord God Almighty. In the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. We honor, we adore you. We thank you, Father, for the gift of life, O God. We thank you, Father, Lord God Almighty, for safety, for how you granted our sisters, O God, for how you granted us joining mercy to this campground. Father, we say thank you. May your name be praised, O Lord. May your name be highly exalted in our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask for mercy, O God. Let your mercy locate us. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. For this section, Father, we pray that you take control. Father, have your way. Have your way, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please, can you have your beautiful seat? Praise the Lord. Amen. I would like to thank the Lord God Almighty for allowing me to speak to his holy and faithful children. I say, who am I? Who am I? I'm nothing. But God chooses whosoever he wants to use. I pray that may his name be praised this morning in Jesus' name. The topic before us this morning is wives obedient to your husband. Wives obedient to your husband. And our text will be taken from the book of Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 5. Ephesians chapter 5,
verse 20, to where I will stop. Giving thanks always for all things unto God
and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit yourself unto your own husbands as unto the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church.
He is the Savior of the body.
Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Praise the Lord. Amen. The Bible says, wife, in everything be submissive to your husband. Praise the Lord. In every institution, there is a leader. Even in Holiness Revival Ministry, there is a leader. Praise the Lord. We have president as a leader over a state. We have governors, a president over a nation, and governors over a state. Praise the Lord. And teachers over students. Employer over employee. Praise the Lord. Amen. And parents over children. We have leaders in various places. Praise the Lord. Why will it be any different in marriage? In marriage, there is a leader. In marriage, there is someone that is the head. Praise the Lord. Many women go to work every day and listen to their own boss in the office. Their boss will give them work to do. They will run heter and skater to see that, yes, they carry on that assignment. Praise the Lord. They listen and obey their boss. Their boss is not their own husband, who they promise to love all the days of their life, through good times and bad times, through sickness and health. Praise the Lord. Amen. They easily obey their boss who doesn't love them and hasn't committed his life to them. And that is what most of us do. We obey our boss. Not that it's wrong to obey your boss, no. But it is good for you to obey your own husband, who among all the millions of ladies out there, he chose but only you to marry. And yet, many of us seems not to obey our husbands, but we do what? We disobey them. Praise the Lord. Out of all the men in the world, you have chosen to marry this one man, your husband, and live with him till death do you part. Your goal is to do what? Is to please your husband. That should be your primary goal, to please your own husband. Your goal also is to, you should be what? You should have a peaceful home. That should also be your goal, to please your husband and also have a peaceful home. Children strive
in a peaceful home. Amen. Where there is love, where there is kindness, and where there is joy. Praise the Lord. A house divided against itself can never stand. Praise the Lord. But a house united stand. Praise the Lord. And we have different kinds of husbands. We have those that are professionals. We have those that are characters. Or we have different types of husbands. My experience will not be your own experience. And your own experience may not be my own experience. We have the professionals such as the pastors, the politicians, the handwork, the civil servant, the businessmen, and students. All in these categories, I believe each and every one of us, our husbands, fall on this profession. Praise the Lord. The pastors, their own duty is to do what? They are ministers of the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To feed us on the word of God, to encourage us on the word of God, and to put us through. Praise the Lord. Amen. You can get that in the book of Acts, chapter 18, verse 24 to 28. Praise the Lord. It's about Aquila and Priscilla. Praise the Lord. And we have the politician too. And their own primary duty is they are what? They seek leadership. They seek leadership position in the secular society. Praise the Lord. Including all Muslims, Christians, pagans, and so on. Praise the Lord. And so on and so forth. We have the handwork, the mechanic, the carpenter, and so on. All the handwork, we have them as our own husbands. Praise the Lord. We have the civil servant, those that work in the ministry, those that work in an organization. Praise the Lord. And the businessmen too. Praise the Lord. We have the international businessmen, even as we are told here yesterday about a man who married a wife, and the wife had to divorce him because she said she did not marry what? She did not marry money, but she married a husband. And the husband is nowhere to be found. Praise the Lord. He's busy with his business, taking care of his business, and leaving the wife. Praise the Lord. And we also have students, and so on and so forth. Praise the Lord. We have characters, different kinds, different types of characters. We have some are loving. Some husbands are what? They are loving. They are loving. Some are simple, as simple as ABCD. Some husbands are simple. Some are inquisitive. They like to ask questions. They want to know everything. They want to know details, how it happens. We have different kinds of husbands, different kinds of men, all characters. Praise the Lord. So my word, small thing get them angry easily. They get angry so easily. Praise the Lord. Some are not abiding, not staying at home. I would like us to look at them maybe one by one. First, I would like us to open to 1 John. 1 John chapter 4, verse 7. It says, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not, not. He that loveth not, knoweth not God, for God is love. In this was manifested the love of God towards us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we may live through him. Herein is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us, and sent his Son to be the propitiation of our sins." Beloved, if God so loved us, we ought also to love one another. Praise the Lord. You can see here, God says we should love one another. If you claim that you love God, you're supposed to first love your brother or your sister that you are seeing physically. Praise the Lord. So this morning, some husbands are loving. What if you find out and discover that you got married, the husband you marry is so loving, and end up having a nagging wife? There won't be peace in that home. Praise the Lord. There won't be peace in that home. And so, I'm encouraging us this morning as sisters that we should love our husband, cherish them, love them, no matter the cost. Love your husband. Praise the Lord. If you love your husband, he will shower you with all kinds of gifts. But if you don't love him, you won't see him at home. Praise the Lord. Men, they like a peaceful environment where there is love, where there is care. Praise the Lord. Some are simple, so simple that we women will take advantage of. Because your husband is simple, you think you will override him. It's wrong. Praise the Lord. Very, very wrong. If you marry a simple husband, you too have to obey him. That is what the Bible says. That wives, obey your husband. The Bible did not say disobey, no, but obey them. This is the man that paid your price, paid your bride price, and married you. It's because he loved you. If not, he wouldn't have go on with the marriage. Praise the Lord. Amen. Some are so inquisitive, they like to ask questions. They want to know everything that happened in their absence. Praise the Lord. And some, they easily get angry. Even if their wife did not do anything to them, easily, anything the wife does or do, irritate them. Hey, I don't like it. Hey, shut up, this and that. Praise the Lord. Some husbands are like that. As a wife, all what you need to do is to pray. Praise the Lord. Amen. And some are abiding. They are not staying at home. They will come after from work. They will come briefly. They've gone out. Praise the Lord. My husband was like that too. He would just come. Before you know it, he's already out. I begin to wonder what is so good out there. What is it that is taking his attention out there? So we women, we need to check ourselves. Check yourself very well. If you want that loving husband of yours to be staying at home, check yourself. Praise the Lord. Amen. Things husbands like. There are so many things that husbands like. Some like. All husbands, they like good food, well prepared. Praise the Lord. And that is what most of the ladies or our sisters don't know how to do. They don't know how to cook good food. Praise the Lord. If you don't know how to cook good food, ask from others. Please, teach me how to prepare so and so food. It's not an offense. Praise the Lord. It's not a sin. Something that you don't know, you ask. When you go to some houses, you see that when the woman cook, for you to even the plate that she present this food to the husband, even dogs can't use that plate to eat. Praise the Lord. That is what most of us sisters are doing. We don't regard our husband as something. We regard them as nothing, as if they are nothing. Praise the Lord. May it not be our portion in Jesus' name. And another thing I would like to talk about is sex. Praise the Lord. Men like sex. Men, they like sex. Free availability of sex. A lady told me that every night before she go to bed, she have to wear pants, have to wear skin tight before she go to bed. for Christ's sake. If you are in this man's shoe, what will you do? That you go to bed, you have to struggle with your wife to remove her pants, to remove her skin tight. If you are in this man's shoe, what will you do? It's a question I'm asking us. And that is what most of us are doing. Hey, leave me alone. Hey, I'm not interested. Shoe? You think you are in the house to do what? To be watching television? That is the primary duty of every woman. Praise the Lord. Your wife, your duty there in the house is to satisfy him to the fullness. Praise the Lord. Any type of style he wants, give it to him. Yes, I said, give it to him. Is it not his property? Is your body your body? No. And his own body too is not his, it's yours. So why denying him? Why denying your husband your body? Please, if you want to make heaven, stop denying your husband your own body. Stop it. Don't allow this man to go out there and fall into the hands of the Jezebel. Praise the Lord. Because if this man falls into the hands of Jezebel, it won't be good for you. That is the beginning of your sorrow. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Cleanliness. Most of us, we only know how to take care of our body. But we don't bother much about the whole, the environment we live in. Even the toilet, we don't know how to clean our toilet. Praise the Lord. Some don't know how to take care of even their bed that they sleep upon. Praise the Lord. We will pray for God's mercy. Praise Master Jesus. You have to be clean in and out. Not only your physical body. No, even in your home, in your house. You have to be clean. Cleanliness is very, very important. Your husband won't go out there to office and come back and meet a dirty environment, dirty home. No. He will quickly go out. What am I here for? Look at the place. Look at the house. Look at the bedroom. You sit down and tie wrapper from morning to evening in your chest, doing nothing. Busybody doing nothing. Praise the Lord. Men like a clean environment. Playfulness, and jokes. Some men like to play with their wives. Anyway, you have to play before you get into action. Praise the Lord. Some women are very difficult to calm when in bed. Until you play. Praise the Lord. And some, easily, you just see them, they'll just come. Praise the Lord. And when I talk of playfulness and jokes, some men like to crack jokes with their wives. Why some wives, they are not interested. That is not their own problem. That is, don't even go there. Even if the man is playing with you, don't even go there. Don't even try that one. Is very, very wrong. Praise the Lord. And I will also like us to what? Listen to him. Listen to your husband. When your husband wants to talk, give him your full attention. Put down the phone. Some, their husband is talking, they'll tell him, keep quiet, I'm on the phone. Let me finish. Shoo. That means you are the boss in the house. You are the boss in the house. If you will shut your husband down to keep quiet, you're on the phone, that means you are the boss. But I would like to tell us this morning, don't do that. Listen to him. When he is talking, put down whoever is calling you, even if it is your own parent, tell them, oh, sorry, mom, I'm with my husband, please, I'll call you back later. Even if they are your friend, even your boss in the office, we understand. Praise the Lord. Amen. Am I talking to the living? Yes. Amen. Yes. Put down the phone or computer or remote control. Listen to him. Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm making love to, I've said that earlier, by responding to his advance. Some, we are like firewood. When they keep us in one, keep us, when we lay down on the bed, we are just like firewood. No moving. The man will play. You will respond. Very, very wrong. You have to respond. Praise the Lord. For you to enjoy one another, you have to respond. Praise the Lord. When you respond, you are communicating your loyalty to him, your selfless love for him, and your what? Your attraction to him. Praise the Lord. Involve him in your daily life. You each have your own routine, your hobbies, your own friends. Make it a habit to include him in your activities, to talk about what is going on. It's very, very important. Hello, dear. I don't know what you call your husband, whether it's honey, whether it's sugar, whether it's baby. Call him. Praise the Lord. We shouldn't be shy. No. It's your own husband. Is it not your husband? Yes. Your own husband. So you should have a name to call him. Some call their husband daddy. Some call their husband honey, darling, and so on. Call him. Don't wait when he goes to office until when he comes back. No. Are you okay? Are you all right? Okay, may the Lord bless you. Bless your husband. It's very, very important. Praise the Lord. Don't put down your husband in front of others, especially your children, your relations, and your friends. Try and find something good to say about him, and even brag about him a little. It's very good to brag. Yes. Ah, my husband is this, my husband is that. Thank God. Praise the Lord. If you don't do it, other guests out there will do it for you. Don't put down your husband in front of your relation. That is what most of us do. Some will say, hey, keep quiet. No, this one is wrong. For crying out loud, it's wrong. Don't ever do that. As children of God, respect your husband. Give them that due respect that they deserve. Praise the Lord. Put a positive spin in things that annoy you. If you find it boring when he spent time telling you about his bad day, remember that at last he is talking to you. At least he is talking to you, spending time with you, sharing his concern with you, bringing you into his own confidence, and giving you the chance to what? To respond. Praise the Lord. Maybe he's out there in the office and somebody got him annoyed. At least when he's home, he tried to share the experience he got in the office, and you are here trying to shut him down. It's very, very wrong. Try to understand him. Try to calm him down. Praise the Lord. I remember in 2005, my husband came back and was like, a lady slapped me. I said, shoo. I thought it was a joke. She was also a member in House of Representatives. I think they got into argument. She now raised her hand and slapped him on the face. Praise the Lord. The whole paper at that time in 2002 carried it all. And he didn't respond. He didn't beat her back. Praise the Lord. He came home, he was talking, he told me about it. I was like, wow, a lady beat you, and you that I know, you did not fight back. Huh. Praise the Lord. The Lord has started doing good things in your life. Praise the Lord. Amen. Locate your husband and satisfy him. Study your husband and know him very well. Ask him questions to understand him. Ask questions. You don't just sit boom. Like a statue, no. Ask questions. Ask him things he likes, things he doesn't like. Ask questions. ask your husband question. Find out also from God what God wants to do and how to do about it. What God wants you to do and how to go about it. Praise the Lord. Ask God, go into your private corner and pray to God. God, how do I go on? How do I do this thing? Help me. Come to my aid. Praise the Lord. I remember when I married him, if I were to tell you my life's experience, I think we would spend the whole day here. But thank God for Jesus. Thank God for this ministry. That now I have a loving husband, I have a caring husband, and I have a wonderful husband. Thank God for this ministry. Thank God for Daddy Paul Rica and the wife, for how God is using them. For how God is using them in my family. I will forever be grateful, Daddy. May the Lord's name be praised in Jesus' name. Go all out to do it, not minding the cause. Go all out to find out. Try to please your own husband. Whatever it costs you, try. I'm not telling you to go out there to Babalawo to go and start asking for charm. Praise the Lord. No. Go to your private room and kneel down. That is why the Lord God Almighty has given us this kneel. For us women to kneel down and pray unto him. Praise the Lord. It's not all about that day that you got married, you wear that wedding gown. I always tell my children in the house, I say it's not all about that. No, it's more than that. Until the two of you come together and stay 1 month, 1, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, that's when you start seeing the true color of man. Praise the Lord. And he too will start seeing the true color of you. Praise the Lord. All you need to do is to pray. Praise the Lord. Apply fasting and prayers for his favor, love, joy. Pray for him. Something happened to us when we pray for people. Our hearts soften, our compassion and emptiness increase, and we gain spiritual insight as to what the other person is going through. So, pray for your husband. Ask God to give him wisdom, protection, guidance, knowledge, spiritual maturity, success, purity, and courage. Ask God all this for your husband. Pray. Even if it means your husband beats you every day, pray for him. Praise the Lord. Amen. There is this woman that every day the husband will beat her up, he will kick her. When people come to separate them, you know, she will like, let him die, let me rest. The man should die, let me rest. Every day beating. One day the man died. She was crying. When friends came in, they said, is that not what you wish for? So we should be very, very careful the way we use our tongue. Praise the Lord. Life and death is in the power of tongue. Praise the Lord. We should be very, very careful the way we use our tongue. Use your tongue to bless your husband. Each and every blessed day, bless him. Oh, may the Lord God Almighty bless you. Yes, bless him. Praise the Lord. And thank God for how he has worked within your family and for giving you this man. Pray for your attitude to change rather than looking for your husband's flaws. Praise the Lord. Ask God for strength. Ask God for strength. The Bible says, wives, submit yourself unto your own husband as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. And he is the savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husband in everything. I would like to hear answer. In every. Amen. Submit yourself to your husband in everything. Not some things. Everything. Your body. Everything that concerns you. Praise the Lord. Not when he comes, you shut him. No. Submit to him. Whatever it takes, submit. Whether you are interested to, whether you are not interested, submit yourself to your husband. The Bible commands wife to obey their husband. We can see that in 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 1 to 5 and Ephesians chapter 5 verse 24. And we don't have much time. Let me just rush so that we'll have time to pray. Praise the Lord. A wife is to be subject means to obey her own husband. If you are a woman, God will punish you if you disobey your husband. Yes. If you disobey your husband, God will punish you. And the kingdom of God is not for you. Praise the Lord. If you are a Christian couple and you drag your husband through court, you are seeking for divorce. There is no divorce. No divorce. Once you are married, you are married. No divorce. Praise the Lord. No divorce. No matter what it takes, there is no divorce. Praise the Lord. Always, as I said earlier, always pray for your husband. I remember some years back when my husband was into all these habits, chasing after ladies, and he smokes, he drinks. I was not having that affection. I was not having that, yes, that affection, but I keep praying to God. I keep praying. It doesn't mean that you will speak in tongues. No! That heart that you pray unto God, that secret, that one that is inside of you, that you pray to God in your closet, God one day will answer your prayer. I don't know what you are passing through in your home. I don't know what you are facing in your own home. I just don't know. But your story may be different from mine. I've passed through that. I've married a man who is a drunk. Drink. Oh, when it's time for Christmas, oh God, have mercy. The kind of drink that he will drink that time or that day is only God that knows. He will be drunk and, oh Jesus. You won't even see him at home. The girls are there. He smokes. That was then. But thank God. Thank God. Thank God. The little prayer that I was then praying in the secret, the Lord God Almighty come to my aid. And I will forever be grateful unto God. I will forever be grateful unto God. And the Lord God that did it to me, he will also do it to you. Tell your husband what you appreciate him. Do you think it's easy to pay school fees? My sisters, is it easy to pay your children's school fees? Appreciate them. Oh, whatever name you are calling him, for my husband, darling, sweetheart, daddy, thank you. May God bless you. Thank you for paying these children's school fees. Thank you for feeding us. Thank you for putting food on our table. Oh, thank you. Appreciate them. Even, you know, human beings, we like to hear that word, thank you. We understand. So thank God for the life of your husband. Appreciate him with the little he's doing. Whether he pays their school fees or not, appreciate them. Praise the Lord. It's better for them to be there than them not to be there. Praise the Lord. At least they are what? They are an umbrella covering you. Praise the Lord. It's really nice to hear the word thank you. Even in better time or in bad time, just tell your husband thank you. Appreciate him. By telling your husband you appreciate him, or you appreciate, yes, by telling your husband you appreciate what you appreciate about him, communicate your love and respect and gratitude to him. Appreciate him for provision, for everything. Praise the Lord. Amen. I don't know which one you fall into, but this morning I would like us to be on our feet. I would like us to be on our feet to appreciate our husband. Thank God for the husband he has given you. Appreciate the Lord God Almighty for the kind of husband he has given you. You have a better chance to change him through your prayer. You are in a better place now in Horemore to change your husband. Some women are fond of complaining. Even if your husband is bad, don't complain. Go to God in prayer. Don't complain. Pray to God to change him. Pray to God to transform him. Open your mouth and pray unto God. Father, change my husband. Change him. Change my husband, Lord. I can't hear us pray. Father, change my husband. Change him to that man I want him to be. I remember during my time when I was praying, I said, Father, I would love to see my husband stand and preach your word. These girls that he's running after, let him draw these girls to you. And praise the Lord God Almighty. The Lord God has answered my prayer. So pray. I don't know what you are believing God for in the life of your husband. Pray to God this morning. Pray to God this morning. After appreciating God for your husband, pray to him. That which you want him to be. Open your mouth and pray. Father, transform my husband. Change my husband, oh Lord. Change his attitude, oh Lord. Change his attitude, oh Lord, towards me. Change my husband's attitude towards me. Put the love, my love in his heart. Father, put my love in the heart of my husband. Let him love me. Let him cherish me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray in Jesus' name. I can't hear us pray. Open your mouth and pray. Father, change my husband. Change my husband. I don't want my husband to miss heaven. Change him. Change him, oh Lord. I don't want my husband to miss heaven. Father, your mercy. Your mercy. Let your mercy locate my husband. Let your mercy, oh God, locate him. Wherever he is, Father, let your mercy locate my husband. Father, let your mercy, O God, locate my husband, O God. Let your mercy locate my husband. Open your mouth and pray. Let the mercy of God locate your husband, wherever he is. Let your mercy, O God, locate my husband. Open your mouth and pray. Let the mercy of God locate your husband, wherever he is. Even if he beat you at home, let his mercy, let God's mercy locate your husband. Let God's mercy locate your husband. Your mercy, Lord. I ask for your mercy. Let it locate my husband. If God will change my own, he will change your own. Your own will not be of different. He will change your own. He will change your husband. He will transform your husband. Father, transform him, O God, for your service, O God. Open your mouth and pray, my sisters. Open your mouth and pray to your husband. And at times, it's not their own fault. There are forces working against your home. There are forces working against your marriage. Every evil covenant and witchcraft decreed troubling the peace of my marriage, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Every witchcraft decree, open your mouth and pray. Every covenant and witchcraft decree troubling the peace of my marriage, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it break in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth this morning and pray in Jesus' name. Every witchcraft, every evil covenant and witchcraft, Every evil covenant and witchcraft, decree troubling the peace of your marriage. My sisters, open your mouth and pray. Troubling your marriage, let it break in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it break, O God Almighty. Let it break, O God. Let it break. Let it break. Let it break. I break every witches, every witchcraft, O God Almighty, concerning my marriage, in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, let peace, joy, financial prosperity of my husband be restored back today. Let peace, joy, financial prosperity of my husband be restored back today in the mighty name of Jesus. My sister, let's pray. There are forces that are working against our marriages. There are forces. So let's take this time and pray. My Father, let peace, let joy, and financial prosperity of my husband be restored back today in the mighty name of Jesus. Pray for peace, joy, and financial prosperity in the life of your husband. Pray for peace. Pray for joy. Pray for financial prosperity in the life of your husband. Let it be restored back today in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it be restored back today in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it be restored by Father Lord. Father, let it be restored by Father, O God. Let it be peace, O God. Joy, O God, reign in my home. In the mighty name of Jesus, pray for peace in your home. Pray for joy in your home. Pray for peace, that let peace reign in your home. Let peace reign in your home. Father, I ask for peace in my home, O God. Let your peace, Father, Lord God Almighty, reign in my home. Let your peace reign in my marriage. Let there be peace, O God, between me and my husband. Let there be peace between me and my husband. Let there be peace. Let there be love. Let my husband cherish me. Let him love me. Let me love him. Let me cherish him in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Let joy, let peace reign in your home. Peace, peace in your heart. Peace in your home. Peace in your marriages. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Father, I bless you, Lord, Lord, Lord. Father, I bless you, Lord, Lord, Lord. I pray for peace. Your peace, O God. Your peace, O God. Your peace, O God. Your peace, O God. In my home, O God. In my home, O God. In my home, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, let your peace, O God. In my home. Let your peace in my home. Let your peace in my home. Let it reign. Let your peace reign. Let your peace reign. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let your peace reign in my home.
Let there be abundance of love in my home, O God. Let there be abundance of love in my home. Oh, Father God Almighty, arrest my husband. Arrest him, O God Almighty. mighty. I call upon you, O God Almighty. I call upon you, O Lord God Almighty. Arrest him, O God. Arrest him, O Lord God Almighty. Arrest him, O God. Arrest him, my Lord and my King. Arrest him, O God. Let him spread this word of the law in the whole corner of this world. Arrest him, O God, for the sake of the gospel. Arrest my husband, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Okay, sir. Oh, you my husband. Mention your husband's name. Oh, you Emmanuel Boacha. It's my own husband's name you people are calling. Call your own husband's name. Praise the Lord. Amen. Oh, you my husband. I command you to arise and shine. I command you to arise and shine in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, you Emmanuel Bacha, I command you to rise and shine. I command you to rise and shine. I command you to arise and shine to the glory of God the Father. I command you to arise and shine. No man shall stop your destiny. I command you to arise and shine. No man, no woman born of woman will stop your destiny. I command you to arise and shine to the glory of God the Father. To the glory of God the Father. To the glory of God the Father. Arise and shine, Emmanuel Boacha. Arise and shine. Arise and shine. Arise and shine. Arise and shine. Arise. Arise, Emmanuel Boacha, arise. Arise, I command you as a wife, I command you as a wife that may you arise and shine to the glory of God the Father. Arise and shine, Emmanuel Boacha. Arise and shine. Arise and shine. No woman, no man born of woman will stop your destiny. No woman, no man born of woman will stop your destiny. And so arise, 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 arise and shine. In the mighty name of
the message you have just listened to is a production of Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide. Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide is a non-denominational ministry that is given to the propagation of Christ's righteousness and holiness in churches and nations of the world through crusades, revival meetings, production and spread of holiness literature and materials. For other spiritual materials, messages or inquiries, contact us on 0816-902-3948 or 0805-683-4323. You can also reach us through our email address, holinessrevivalmovement@gmail.com. God bless you.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Hallelujah. Jesus, I believe in you. You are my Lord and Savior. I believe in you. You are the living Savior. I believe.
Savior, Jesus, I believe.
purchased me with your blood. You are my Lord and my Savior. You left your throne above and took up the form of a servant for my sin. I believe in you,
'cause you are my Lord and Savior.
You are my Lord and Savior.
Jesus, I believe in you.
I believe in you,
Lord, 'cause you are
a living Savior.
Jesus, I believe.
You are the living Savior.